Hello everyone and welcome to Restoration Weekly. In this episode we're gonna do something really interesting. Let's set up the scene first. So let's say you're working on a project that needs to be done quite quick and you don't have a lot of budget, or it's a project that was done by a previous artist in another facility, in another time. Maybe it was done because, I don't know, any type of constraint that you can imagine. So in the end, they end up using some type of tool that doesn't require any type of manual quality control. What I mean by that is using, I don't know, maybe automatic deal removal in Resolve, maybe need video, maybe some AI algorithm that they found online, I don't know, anything. The problem is that those filters, I mean, they are not bad, they can do the job, but problem is they don't have any type of measures for recovering false positives, any type of artifact that was created, because the detection of the software, it didn't detect what it needed to detect in that particular frame, so it deleted some type of feature, maybe a hand, maybe a flash, something that is considered part of the picture. What we're gonna do is we're gonna use that output and we're gonna try to recover it using the original. Let's watch the original. So the original that we're gonna work here is gonna be a 1967 trailer for the movie Point Blank with Lee Marvin. Yeah, you can see this is a positive print of the trailer. Seems to be really worn down. Dust, flicker, but it was properly scanned, I believe, with a good scanner. We can see the stabilization on the left. This seems to be quite good. So we don't have to worry about stabilization. Nothing that you haven't seen before, especially if you're in this line of work. Okay, so we have this. This is the original, and let's see the restore output our boss or the other facility send us. So this is the restore output. In this particular case, it was done with DaVinci Revival or DaVinci Resolve with the automatic deal removal. At first glance, yeah, it looks okay. I mean, you can still have some of those dust here and there, but they can be, well, you can do that manually. If you know this carefully, you can start seeing these artifacts, especially these artifacts that are motion artifacts, though, is because you can see the gun is doing a kind of a big flash, and that flash is recognized as something that needs to be clean. The software does its best trying to fill up using the bug and whatever features they can find. It's not really bad, but since we don't have any type of measures to do the normal recovery that you will do in using dry clean in Phoenix or dust or whatever, we cannot recover this. Unless we are doing some type of fusion, I don't know, pipeline that can mix the original. It's gonna be quite complex to do that. And if you don't have the time to do this properly in another restoration software, you're surely not gonna have enough time to do that procedure in fusion. So our boss tells us, Fabio, okay, we need to work with this and you need to make it work. You're gonna do the recovery on those places that you find that the most artifacts are present. So we scan the picture. Most of the part is gonna be okay. Let's move. I found a particular place when you can see, especially on the guns, yeah, but let's worry about the guns later. So here, when Lee Marvin is getting hit, slapped by the lady here, yeah, you can see the hand is disappearing, and then you're gonna see the handbag is gonna be disappearing as well. So let's say we mark this particular shot for recovery. So what do we do? How is the procedure for doing this history brush, as the people in Diamond of Dagbuster would call it? We're gonna create a second tract here in this composition. Here we can create a new tract. And remember, we want the output, the clean output, to be on top, and the original to be on the bottom, because we are gonna punch holes on the alpha on the top so the bottom track can come through on those particular holes that we are punching. I'm gonna exemplify that. We can create a new track, and then we're gonna move this particular clip upwards. So we disable this, because if we have this enabled, when we move the track upwards, it's not gonna move because we have both tracks selected. So we need to disable this, and then we move it upwards. So now we have this track in the top track, and we are gonna take the original and we're gonna put it on the bottom track. Same thing, we're gonna disable the top track in order for us to place the bottom track in place, and we're gonna put the original on the bottom. If we go here, and we can enable or disable the track one or track to right now. We are seeing the clean output, and we're gonna disable to see the original. So you can see a lot of articles. We want to recover this particular shot. You may need to cut the bottom track as well, because I'm gonna teach you something that in most cases you're gonna have the clean output, and the original output is not gonna be the original scan. It's gonna be an original scan that had an stabilization process or a deflicker process, because when we are doing this type of punching holes, history blasting, we need the pixels to be in the same place, because if we do the recovery, if the pixels are in a different place, the pixels are gonna be misaligned when they come through. We need both outputs to be kind of the same, except for the removal or the scratch removal. Let's start by doing this here. Okay, so first thing we are going to do, we need to use a composite mode. The composite mode, you can find it here, is called create new composite layer for active shot. It's gonna create a composite effect here. If we enter that, we have the different composite modes that we can find available. At the moment it's called easing over by default. Over means A over B, top track over bass, as simple as any compositing program that you may use in the last 30 years or so. We can use any type of composite operation here, add, subtract. If we use subtract, you can see what's missing. If we want to see what's missing without messing with these settings, still use over, but use a comparison mode. At the moment I'm using red, and since I am on track 2, I'm gonna be comparing with track 1. Nothing really out of the ordinary. We can use red, we can use luma, we can use subtraction, we can use subtraction by 10. Any of these works. And the same as you know before, we can set up how much of that information we wanna see. We can adjust the compare different threshold to be increased. By default is 5. You can see a lot of the grain is starting to show up, but let's do it 20, 25, or let's do only the biggest one, let's say 100. If we go 100, yeah, we know what's missing. For this particular example, let's do 40. I think 40 is a good measure for this particular project. In some projects, if you want to have a better quality, you might lower these or go higher, whatever. It's up to you and the creator, the place you're working. So we have the composite mode set, and the other thing that we need to use is use this base CC layer that comes by default in every shot. We go to the router here, and the alpha output, the bottom one, needs to go to this layer. We have finished any type of cell. We go here to matte paint, and then we just need to find whatever we need to recover. Let's say this particular shot with the hand here. Same procedure with the matte paint as we always did. We just paint this, and paint this, paint this, paint this. You can see we are recovering the picture. You do this where you find it necessary, where your boss finds it necessary, and it's a quick way to clean up and to recover these lost parts of the picture that somebody else made and they didn't have any proper QC procedures. So yeah, we can start going over this. I don't know if you are faster than me, I am faster than you. Yeah, you need to be sure you are not recovering dust. I try not to recover dust, but I kind of know where things are. You just go through the motions. Okay, if you find, let's say you have recovered some type of dust or whatever, you can just paint it with a traditional DVO fix or whatever. I just kind of know where I can find these artifacts, especially in the moving places. I know the size. Yeah, you just need to be aware of this. Let's see this. Okay, we still have some of this here. Wow, it's quite hard, right? And you can see without recovery, with recovery, without recovery, with recovery. Wow, the hand is missing. Here we have recovered this hand and the head. Wow, a lot of things that need recovery here. Yeah, we need to see them using the different threshold. If not, we're not gonna be able to see them. yeah, this is pretty much it. You just need to be aware. And of course, we are not redoing this restoration. We are just trying to fix whatever was done. Because you, maybe your boss tells you, man, Thaddeus, you have like this afternoon to do this. Or maybe you have one day, tops two, to do the recovery. And yeah, you have to do whatever you can with the time you have allotted. You need to recover and make it work. I know most people in restoration, they don't like this type of stuff because it diminishes the work that we do, especially reservation-wise. But sometimes that's the job. Sometimes people just want a quick, fast restoration that can be streamed or maybe screened for a couple of people, and then that's it. Maybe just want the money for the grant, maybe a national grant. That's the thing that happens in my country as well, because people just want the money, so they just do whatever they can as fast as possible, as quick as possible, as cheap as possible. Maybe we can do this to try to fix those mistakes. Maybe those mistakes come from the scan, but yeah, this is a solution. Just giving you a solution for this type of stuff. And you will say, okay, I get it. So this is the same thing as the history brush, as I told you, in Dustbuster in Diamond. But we have a big advantage here in Phoenix when we are doing this type of procedures. Because since each of these tracks have individual clips, both of them can be applied different effects. So let's say you want to recover something and apply a flicker. Any type of procedure, you can do it on the base and it's gonna be punched upwards on the top track. Maybe you wanna do some clarity here or whatever. You can do things on the base and they're gonna be reflected. Maybe you can match different types of grains. Let's say maybe what happened is that automatic dirt removal has moved some grain and maybe you wanna match that grain. At those places where you're punching the holes, maybe the grain is not in the same place, so we can do clarity on the base, and then everything that's gonna come through, maybe the image wasn't properly stabilized, and you can do some type of adjustment, manual adjustment, or doing a steady or frame lock in order for make the frames be as close as possible. So you can do this type of stuff, so to make both of the tracks fit so they can work together. It's more flexible, it needs some setup, but it does the same job and it gives you more flexibility and it makes you understand the process better so you can know exactly what you're doing. You are punching holes through the alpha so the original can come through. Or, well, not the original, but the original plus stabilization, the original plus flicker can come through. So that's the main idea. As always, I'm gonna share the project and where you can find the video and everything. See you next time and thank you for watching.